On today's video, we are gonna take a look at my top three esports stocks, so let's get started. Like I mentioned, today we're gonna take a look at three esports stocks, and the first one we're gonna take a look at is Google. And the way this episode is gonna break down is, first, I'm gonna take a look at the company, how they are involved in the esports and why I'm so bullish in that certain sector. Then we're gonna take a look at past revenue, past margins growth, the balance sheet real quick, and just take a look at the overall company. Before we go any further, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the thumbs up, and the bell. It helps the small channel out so much, and I truly appreciate all the support I'm getting from you guys. And if you guys ever want to get in contact with me, feel free to catch me on Twitter or on Discord. All the information should be in the comments below. And finally, let me know in the comments below which video you guys want me to do next. I have about 9 esports companies that I'm very bullish on, so I don't know if you guys want me to do with the other 3, the next 3. Right now, these are going to be my top 3, but they're, like I said, I have 9 different companies that I'm very bullish in esports. So if you guys want me to do the next 3, let me know. Another way I can do is 3 cloud stocks that I'm in, or 3 payment stocks that I'm very bullish on. So like I said, let me know in the comments below which one you guys want me to do next. All right, so like I mentioned, the first one we're going to take a look at is Google. Google right now has a market cap of $965 billion, and this is a very big company. So many people might not know how they are involved in the esports market. So the first one I'm going to talk about is YouTube Gaming. So we all know, right? Google owns YouTube, and YouTube is one of the biggest platforms where everybody goes and watches content. YouTube within itself has a different section called YouTube Gaming. Here, I'm taking a look at how YouTube Gaming hours watch compares to the other different platforms which are involved in some form of gaming content. The biggest right now is Twitch, and Twitch is owned by Amazon, and this is for the Q1 2020, which ended on March. So it's between January to March 20th. So right now the biggest is Twitch. Unfortunately, even though the biggest is Twitch, Amazon is such a big company with so different sectors of revenue, that even with Twitch being such a big player in this sector, it barely makes any form of movements in Amazon. Where I do believe YouTube and Google, with Google and the other part we're going to talk about, have huge potential to move the overall business of Google. So like I mentioned, Twitch is the biggest, running about 65% of total hour gaming watched in Q1. The second in place is YouTube Gaming, coming at 22%. We have Facebook Gaming as well. Facebook has also entered this platform. They make up 11%. And the next is Mixer, which is 2%. Mixer is the Microsoft version of Twitch. All right, so the second reason I'm very bullish in Google is them and Nvidia just created something that's called cloud gaming. And 2 things I'm very bullish on is right now clouding and esports. And to be able to actually create something that mixes the two is actually pretty impressive and gets me even more riled up. And I'm pretty happy that Google is in both these sectors, right? So what is cloud gaming? This is the ability to use a weak hardware to be able to play a game or play a video game in any system, right? You can play in your TV, you can play from your phone, you can play from your beaten up computer. So what cloud gaming does, it gives you the ability to sign into a different server, to, for example, Google servers that's running the games in some high powered computer, where now you're just streaming the game from your computer. So your computer doesn't have to use crazy amount of processing power to play the game. So you can be playing the games at high graphic settings, and your computer will be running at very low temperatures. It'll be just like running Netflix on your computer. And I think I'm very bullish in this because it opens up a whole brand new market in the world, right? Obviously, there are certain countries where income is not the same income as here in the United States. So certain families in other countries do not have the ability to purchase a $2,000 gaming computer or a $500 console, right? For example, the PS5 and the Xbox X series are probably going to be over $400, $500. And even for people here in America, that's still a crazy amount of price. So this allows the ability to not have to purchase that crazy hardware, expensive hardware, and you just have to purchase the games within themselves. And again, this opens up a whole brand new market where now if you have a phone, you can just download the app and play from your phone and just buy the games you want to buy. So I think this is going to open up a whole new market out there. I actually use it. I use it a lot. The other reason I'm bullish between this is, like I mentioned, right now there is a big rush into becoming a game streamer, just like me, right? There is a big rush to becoming some kind of YouTube master. Similar with this, it allows people that don't and to stream games and play the games at the same time. You need some crazy amount of power in your laptop to be able to do that. Now with this, you're able to play the game without using that much processing power, and your computer can now just do the streaming part, which is, again, another sector that I feel a lot of people are moving into. And one thing I did not mention, I did do an overview of the whole esports market a few days ago. I'll probably post the link up here, so it'll show up if you guys want to check that out later, to see why I'm so bullish in the esports market, where these are more just the overall companies I'm liking in the esports. So like I mentioned, right now, two reasons I'm very bullish in Google is for YouTube gaming, which is such a strong streaming platform, and then Google Stadia, the cloud gaming, which is at a very beginning point in its life right now, but I can see that this can be a big winner in the long term of things. So now let's take a look at Google's revenue. And remember, if you guys were listening, I did mention that Amazon had the biggest game streaming platform, Twitch, but I didn't believe that their platform would actually create much revenue for the overall Amazon empire. But I do think that YouTube gaming will have some form of effect on YouTube and its revenue. So right now, the main way YouTube makes money is through advertisement. For example, this past quarter of March 31st, this company made about $41 billion. Out of that $41 billion, $33 billion were from advertisement. $4 billion of that, so about 10%, comes from YouTube ads. So now when you have game streaming, when you have an increase of game streaming, of more people watching streaming, streaming platforms, this is gonna help that ad revenue increase from YouTube ads. Again, another thing is esports as a whole is more of a big, giant sponsor platform, which I think is also going to end up leading to greater things for Google and its just YouTube ads applications. All right, so next let's take a look at Google's revenue growth as a whole. This is a big company and it's pretty impressive. In 2019, the company grew about 18%. In 2018, it grew about 23%. In 2017, it grew about 22%. And in 2016, it grew another 20%. So we can see this, even though it's a big company, it still has very strong revenue growth. And that's something you don't see. And like I said, with all the things is coming up, I believe that this revenue is going to continue at this kind of strength. All right, so next let's take a look at gross and profit margins for Google. On the most recent years, gross margins were 55% and profit margins were 21.2%. On average, it does seem like this is the normal. It does seem like there has been a downtrend in gross margins, but the profit margins seem to be pretty stable. Like I said, 21% is actually not bad, especially for a big company like this. For them to be able to keep that much amount of profit, I think is pretty impressive. But remember, this is also a company that's growing really strong in revenue. So it's safe to assume that this company is actually using a lot of its money to continue that growth. So eventually we're gonna start seeing these profit margins continue to increase and increase. Next, I just wanted to take a look at this company's most recent balance sheet. And this is coming from their most recent earnings that were for the end of March 31st. First, this company has non-current debt of about $15 billion. And that's pretty much any debt this company has. And it has quick cash of close to $120 billion. I'm adding that $98 billion of current investments with $20 billion of cash. So this company has more than enough cash to be able to survive any downturns in his business. And I think that's actually very bullish. So Google to me is a company with strong growth, very strong balance sheet. And like I said, I'm very bullish in the esports sector of it. Next, let's just take a look at operating cash flow margins. On average, this company for the past year kept about 33% of its revenue in operating cash flow. So that's actually pretty impressive. You don't see many companies with that kind of margin. And that margin seems to be around the normal. It hasn't seemed to be increasing or decreasing. It seems to flatline. But 33%, this company keeps a good portion of its cash. All right, the next company we're going to take a look at is NVIDIA. And NVIDIA is very similar let's just take a look at the stock price real quick. I didn't have it up, but NVIDIA is very similar to Google, where it's, even though it's not a game developer, it is in the esports market and many people don't know about it. So NVIDIA has a market cap of $219 billion, and again, this is another company that's also in the cloud market, which I am very bullish on. So for me, Google and NVIDIA are two of my top companies for those reasons. So now let's take a look at NVIDIA. Like I mentioned, has a market cap of $220 billion, and what does NVIDIA really have that it puts it in the esports market? The first thing is NVIDIA makes graphics cards that are used in the gaming, in all these gaming rigs, in all these esports laptops that are sponsored. NVIDIA is a huge portion of those computers, right? The graphics card is what you need to be able to run these games at a high resolution and to be able to just run them perfectly. So, and the second part is very similar to Google. They have a program that is that it's kind of like Google Stadia, which is in the cloud gaming platform. So NVIDIA has GeForce Now, which I am actually a member of. And this is actually, again, pretty cool, very similar, where you use your phone, you can use some random laptop, you can use your TV to play any game you want. The hardware doesn't have to be as strong. So like I said, I mentioned this in the Google Stadia platform, where I think it's just gonna open up the overall market. The good thing about this is a subscription-based server. So you're gonna be paying a monthly subscription for this. And we all know right now, subscription is the key. Same with Google Stadia, where it is a subscription service. Now let's take a look at NVIDIA's most recent year and how gaming actually is part of the revenue. So we can see right last fiscal year of 2020, this company had about $11 billion of revenue. We can see right here by this screenshot, let me zoom in. The green is gaming. Gaming makes up a huge portion of this company's total revenue. And this is actually mainly from the graphics card. Right now, it's still not tracking any money from GeForce Now, because that is something that actually just came out in the past few months. And like I said, it's not something I don't think we're gonna see right now. But in the overall sense of the market, I think it's something that is gonna be very, very big. So we can see how NVIDIA is in the esports market. So now let's take a look at this company's growth. Revenue growth in 2019 was unfortunately actually a decline of 7%, 20% in 2018, 40% in 2017, and 37% in 2016. If we take away 2019, this company has had very strong revenue growth. Unfortunately, this company is in the semiconductor industry, and the semiconductor industry usually is very cyclical. And the reason it is cyclical is because sometimes companies just go and buy a little bit too much of graphics card, of data center stuff, that they end up building too much inventory, and then they have to put a hold in certain buys. And that's what actually ended up happening in 2019, where their customers had purchased too much stuff in the previous years, that in 2019 there was a slowdown, which had the revenue growth. Another thing is that was the time, 2018 was the time during the Bitcoin bust and a big Bitcoin boom, where everybody was buying graphics cards to start mining. And this ended up helping the company do huge revenue growth. But then the next year, they saw a decline of the Bitcoin bust. People no longer were mining. beginning, people were selling their graphics cards off the market. So it reduced that growth from NVIDIA. But again, NVIDIA is in two major sectors that I'm very bullish, the esports and the clouding. So that's why NVIDIA makes this list. Next, let's take a quick look at the balance sheet. This company has about $15 billion of cash and cash equivalents in its most recent earnings. And then it only has non-current debt of about $7.4 billion. So this company has enough cash and cash equivalents to pretty much pay off non-current debt. This company did see a huge increase in cash and cash equivalent this most recent quarter. And the main reason is this company did an acquisition after the timeline of its earnings, where it bought Mellanox, which was a company that deals with artificial intelligence in the clouding market. Again, something I'm continuing to see growth in, but this is a video on esports, so let's continue with that. But again, a strong balance sheet, not as strong as Google, right? Because Google has cash for days, but still a very, very strong balance sheet. Next, let's take a look at operating cash flow margins. Unlike Google, this is actually pretty good. The overall cash flow margins has improved. In 2019, cash flow margins were 43%. So this company is able to keep more money, more of its revenue as cash flow operations. And I think that's actually pretty impressive. 43% is a very strong value. All right, and the final company we're gonna take a look at, my top three esports company, is actually finally a video game company. And it's actually pretty funny, right, that even though esports is the market, the previous two companies weren't actual game developers. And my main reason for this is, just like many people talk, right, when there was the whole gold boom, it wasn't all the miners that made the most money. It was the people that created the tools for the miners. And I do think like Google and NVIDIA are the tools that are gonna help out the esports industry. So even though most people are probably focusing on the video game companies, I have more focus on the tools that these video game companies will use. So Activision right now has a market cap of $55 billion. It has had a huge jump, but I really honestly think a $55 billion market cap is pretty low compared to where this company can go. It has a revenue of 2019 of about $6.5 billion. So not even a price to sales ratio of 10, which would, that's where I would probably say it's a little bit overvalued. So I do think there's still plenty of room to grow in all these three companies. So why am I bullish in Activision? Compared to all the other video game companies. First, again, there is this amazing website, Newzoo, which kind of talks about the overall esports world. And we can see in 2019, for the full year of 2019, the top three publishers watched were, number one was Riot Games. Unfortunately, Riot Games is not a publicly traded company, but there is a company that owns Riot, and it's one of my other companies that I would put in my 4, 5, 6. So let me know if you guys actually want me to do that video game. Next is Epic Games. Epic Games was number two. And again, Epic Games is not a publicly traded company, but Epic Games is one that would have made the list if it was, because it owns a lot of great games, and it also owns a game engine that is used to create video games. Again, this is a company that's owned by another company that's in the market, and it's the same company that actually owns Riot Games. So again, if you guys want me to do 4, 5, and 6, let me know in the comments. Number three was Blizzard. And that to me tells, Blizzard is the first one out of these to be in the, to be publicly traded. So that's why Activision made the list. The second thing is Activision has a huge variety of games, where Epic Games and Riot Games, the top games that they play are just Riot Games. Epic Games, I think, is Fortnite, and I forget which one Riot Game is. It's League of Legends, I think. Blizzard has a huge variety of games that are actually pretty good in the esports market. So that's why I am a little more bullish on Blizzard, even though these other companies are bidding Blizzard, because Blizzard is a little bit more diverse. And within this diversity, the overall market within those different companies, within those different sectors, is still very, very big. So now let's take a look at their most recent earnings to take a look at those sectors. So Blizzard owns three sectors. It owns Activision. If you guys know Call of Duty, Call of Duty is doing great right now with this free-to-play type game. I think it's one of the best games coming out right now. It's definitely competing there with Fortnite and Apex. And so Activision, Call of Duty, Call of Duty Mobile, and just the overall Call of Duty franchise is very, very important. The second one is Blizzard, and Blizzard has World of Warcraft, it has Overwatch, it has Hearthstone, it has Diablo, all really strong games again. And in the esports market right now, Overwatch and Hearthstone are very, very big in the esports. And I do think Diablo and StarCraft are very big names overseas. I'm not 100% sure, but I know StarCraft for sure is. The third one is one that many people don't know, and it's King, and this is like Candy Crush. So yes, Activision actually owns Candy Crush, which is actually one of the largest games out there to be played by all types of franchise. I don't think King will have much of an impact in esports, but I do Activision and Blizzard entertainment style games will have major impact in the overall esports world. Now let's take a look at this company's revenue growth. In 2019, similar to Nvidia, this unfortunately saw a decline of revenue of about 13%. In 2018, it saw a growth of 6%. In 2017, it saw another growth of 6%. Again, we're not seeing heavy growth like we did for Google or Nvidia. One thing is to know is this revenue decrease this most recent year was because Activision ended up selling a game that it was partnered with. I don't know if you guys know much about games. Bungie and Activision were both part of Destiny 2. But Activision was like, I don't want to focus on Destiny. I just want to focus on my main game. So it started to sell off those games that it did not want to focus on anymore, which I think is a very, very impressive thing. I think you should always focus on what you're strong with and make sure you become stronger in those. So that's why one reason we see a big drop in revenue this most recent year. Again, with COVID-19 though, more people are buying games. So I do think this year we will see a strong growth for this company. Now let's take a look at margins for Activision. This company's most recent gross margins for 2019 were 67%. That's actually pretty good. Profit margins were 23%. And it does seem like there is an uptrend of profit margins going on. So again, all these companies, both Google, Nvidia, and all three of these companies, Google, Nvidia, and Activision, seem to have a very similar type of gross margins and profit margins. Now let's take a look at this company's balance sheet. This company has about $6 billion of cash, and it only has about $2.7 billion of non-current debt. I actually ended up doing a video of EA Games versus Activision. I'm also put that on the links. If not, just feel free to search my channel. It was very recent. And I actually take a look at two companies, and those are both Activision and EA Games have very, very strong balance sheet. So again, very strong balance sheets in all three of these companies, very good in the esports market overall and how they can improve. And finally, let's actually take a look at cash flow margins. Cash flow margins for Activision are about 28%, so close to 30, low 30s. It's very similar again to the other companies. So these are my top three esports companies. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. Like always, make sure to subscribe, hit the thumbs up and the bell. It helps the small channel out so much, and I truly, truly appreciate it. Take care, guys. Have a good night and see you next time.